Do you want to know how to set up the Lutron Connect app so you can operate Lutron Servoya QS wireless blinds using Amazon Alexa and voice control? In this tutorial, I will show you the various steps I use when I program that type of Lutron system. So without further ado, let's do it. To operate the Lutron Servoya QS wireless blind using the Lutron Connect app, we need first to get those blinds programmed on the Lutron Radio RA2 system, also called RA2. RA2 is a Lutron lighting control system that mainly communicates wirelessly with other Lutron devices such as Lutron dimmers, Lutron wireless keypads, and Lutron wireless sensors. So this is my current setup. I have a Lutron Servoya QS blind. Actually, on this particular demo, I will only use the drive that is the motor that goes inside the tube to operate the roller blind. I have a Lutron Pico controller, which is a remote control. I have a Lutron Radio RA2 main repeater, which is the brain of the system and hosts the Lutron program. It can also be connected to third-party devices if I need to integrate the blinds with other control equipment. Finally, to be able to use the Lutron Connect app, I need to have a Lutron Connect bridge. The Lutron Connect bridge is the piece of equipment that will allow me to integrate with current mainstream home automation systems and services such as Amazon Alexa. So the first step is to fully set up and program the Lutron Servoya QS blind on the Lutron Radio RA2 system. We've already done a tutorial on how to set this up. And if you want to watch that first, you can find the link on the description below or click on the card above. Right, so I've set up my Lutron Radio RA2 system, and at the time of this recording, I'm using version 12.0.1. I have a room called Living Room that contains my Lutron Roller Blind and my Lutron Pico controller, and I program it so my Pico can operate the Lutron Blind. Very simple and easy. I can also operate the Lutron blind for my iPad using the Lutron Connect app. Under Device, in the living room, I can select my Pico remote controller and do a quick test by opening the roller blind and closing it. There you go. I can also select the roller itself and do the same test, as well as using the slider to set the blind to a specific position. So that also works fine. Once I'm happy with this, I'll go to the app settings by clicking on the gear icon on the top left corner. In there, I'm going to select the Amazon Alexa option and select Scene. This is probably an important point to bear in mind. In this particular case, the elements we can access using voice control are scenes. As you can see here, I don't have something called roller blind, for example, only scenes. So I'm gonna have to custom those scenes in my Lutron Radio RA2 system with the element of my choice, be it a blind or various blinds set to specific positions into a particular scene, and then to trigger or call that scene via voice control. So I'm going to click on Add or Remove Scenes and then select the living room. And the scenes that are available here are the scenes that I previously programmed on the Pico controller. Each button on the Pico controller, especially the open and the close button, and to a certain extent the favorite button, can only be set as single or multi-room scene. So I have to set the blind to the position I want into those scenes and then to call that scene via voice control. We also need to note that the scenes on the Pico controller are single action scenes. So if I want to have some sort of scene on and scene off, I will need to create and use two specific scenes. Those actions will be triggered by the on voice command, such as Alexa turn on welcome or Alexa turn on good night, where welcome and good night are the name of my two specific scenes. So in my case, I can select the open scene and give it a voice command that is a bit more relevant for a scene that just opened and change it to welcome or daytime, for example. And I can do the same for the closed scene and call it good night or nighttime. I can also customize the favorite scene if I want to. Then I click on save and done. On the list below, I can see which scene on my RAD 2 system have been given a voice command. We can also see that these are on command only, as previously mentioned. Then, to complete the process, I click on Done again. The Lutron app is giving me a message that now I need Alexa to discover those new settings, and I click on OK. Next, I launch the Amazon Alexa app. So, when is the first time that I connect both systems, the first thing I need to do is to enable the Lutron skill on the Amazon Alexa. So from the home page, I select the main menu and then skill. Then I look for Lutron and select the Lutron Connect skill and then click on Enable. On the next screen, I will have to enter the same login and password I've used when I set up my Lutron Connect app. I click on Sign In and then authorize Alexa to use my account and close the window. From there, I will now go to Smart Home and click on Add Device as advised. Once completed, I receive a notification that Alexa has found two scenes, which is good. Please note that nothing else is shown on devices or group. But when I get to scenes, I found my daytime and nighttime scenes. I can now quickly test the operation of my blind using the voice control. Alexa, turn on daytime.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on nighttime.
Okay.
One last thing I've noticed is that the same command using the off instruction instead of the on will also trigger the very same action. Not the opposite action, exactly the same as the on action that just been set. Alexa, turn off daytime.
Okay.
Alexa, turn off nighttime.
Okay.
That's probably related to the single action scene control, as mentioned before, and shouldn't be of any issue as long as you're aware of it. And that's probably a good thing to bear in mind when setting up a system. Voilà, there you have it. How to set up the Lutron Connect app to operate Lutron Sirvoya QS wireless blinds using Amazon Alexa. Did you set up your system in a different way? And what specific function your clients like the most? Is there any specific feature you would like us to describe a bit more? In any case, please feel free to leave a comment down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you can be updated when the next video is released. Thank you very much. Good luck and talk to you again on the next tutorial.